this is Catherine. If you don't know me, I've been working with people suffering from chronic kidney disease for the last 7 years now. I've helped many of them getting some of their kidney function back. Some patients have even reversed their kidney disease, and today I'm here to give you good news. You can do it too. You can repair your kidney damage and improve your health. All you need is to have a plan. So today's video is all about the correct treatment to repair kidney damage. We are going to focus on those treatments for kidney disease that actually work, okay? So you can use them to create your master plan to get out of kidney disease. Let's start immediately. This is your first step toward a better health. And by the way, if you are new here in 00 Kidney, welcome to our journey together to a better kidney health. Don't forget to subscribe and click the notification bell. And if you're already following me here, if you're one of those subscribers that's always watching me and commenting my videos, this is a shout out to you guys. I wouldn't be here today if it wasn't for you. So thank you. Thank you very much. Now, remember that if you have chronic kidney disease, you should never lose hope. There is still hope even if you're in stage 5. But having CKD means that your kidneys cannot take care of you like they used to. So why not show them some love? Take care of them like they took care of you. No one else can eat healthy for you. No one else can be active for you, and no one else can do the treatments you need to do. In this spirit, let's see how to set up your master plan to defeat chronic kidney disease. Now, the very first thing you need to know is what stage of chronic kidney disease you're in, because many treatments to repair kidney damage are specific for just one or two stages. Let's see. Now, there are 5 stages of CKD, from stage 1, where there are basically no symptoms and no complications, to stage 5. In stage 5 of CKD, you usually need to undergo kidney dialysis and to be put in a transplant list. So, the severity of the symptoms increases as the functionality of the kidneys decreases, right? The stage of chronic kidney disease you're in depends on the GFR, or glomerular filtration rate. That's an accurate measure of how much your kidneys are working. As we can see here, if your GFR is more than 90 or 90% of kidney function, you are in stage 1, okay? Between 89 and 60 is stage 2. Stage 3 is between 60 and 30. And stage 4 is below 30. In stage 5, kidney function is less than 15%. Now, today's video is going to focus more on the symptoms of kidney disease and the correct treatments for each stage. But this only works if you already know what stage you are in and how to read your blood tests, your creatinine levels, and so on. If you don't know what your values are, or if you want to know more about the tests, this video up here is for you. For now, let's say that you know what stage you're in, okay? So, we may focus on the correct treatment to start repair your kidney damage, starting from stage 1 and 2. Very few people get diagnosed at these stages, actually, because as we can see here, there are basically no symptoms. Now, as you can see from my slide, I've added foam in the urine as a symptom of stage 2, but that's actually really difficult to spot. It still happens that people get diagnosed this early, and mainly it's because they have some risk factors for CKD. I'm talking about diabetes, high blood pressure, or a family history of kidney disease. So if you were actually diagnosed in stage 2, well, that's somewhat good news, because you can take care of your health better now and start facing what's causing your problems. In stage 2, your GFR would still be above 60, okay? This would mean that your kidneys are still in a good enough shape to completely do their job of purifying your blood. There are people born with just one kidney that never know this, because you only need half of your kidney function for your body to feel healthy. Okay, here are the treatments, medical procedure and medications for stage 1 and 2. Now, if you are in stage 3, 4 or 5, you can skip this part. There is a link in description to the time frame of the treatment for each stage. And while most of these things are going to be valid for everyone, the main focus in these stages is prevention. You do these steps to avoid losing more kidney function, all right? So, 1. Get checked regularly. Do regular checkups to monitor creatinine and GFR. This will let you know what's your renal function and if it's increasing or decreasing. Now, in stage 2, regular means once in a year. What you should monitor more frequently is your blood pressure and, if you have diabetes, your blood sugar levels. 2. Renal diet. The diet is really important already in these stages. We are still not talking about a real kidney diet here, but limiting sodium and sugar intake can really help. If you have watched my videos about the kidney killer foods, the most dangerous are always the foods with the most sugar and sodium in them. Yes, that's what's damaging your kidneys. So, avoid junk foods, processed foods, and sodas, even diet sodas. Those beverages should come with a health danger label on them, like they do with cigarettes. 3. Lower blood pressure. So, if you have hypertension, that could be what's causing your kidney problems, okay? Take the necessary steps to keep a healthy blood pressure. 4. Keep blood sugar or diabetes under control. Now, diabetes is the number one cause of kidney disease. So, like I've said for blood pressure, everyone needs to keep blood sugar under control to improve their kidney health. 5. Lifestyle changes. This can help basically everyone, no matter the stage. Drink only in moderation. Avoid irregular sleep patterns, exercise regularly, avoid stress. The kidney-friendly diet, the medications, the lifestyle changes, everything we will do is basically aim at keeping blood pressure and blood sugar levels at healthy levels. This will give your kidneys the chance to recover. 6. Avoid painkillers. Regular use of NSAIDs like naproxen, ibuprofen has been proven to cause life-lasting kidney damage, so avoid them. There are other prescription and over-the-counter medications that can cause kidney damage actually. If you want to know more about this, watch this video up here. Now, let's talk about the third stage of chronic kidney disease. Now, looking at this table, it is clear that when we get to CKD stage 3, things are already starting to get a lot worse. GFR is between 30 and 59 milliliters per minute, and that's not enough to get the body rid of all the toxins and scores. This means that changes in blood and in the urine will be a lot more visible, causing symptoms. I mean, real symptoms like fatigue, back pain, and swelling. A lot more people get diagnosed at this stage than those that get diagnosed in stage 2. Unfortunately, getting diagnosed in the most advanced stages is even more frequent because the symptoms in stage 3 are still difficult to notice. So, if you have any doubt, if you are here because you have reasons to think you're at risk for kidney disease, don't wait and get checked as soon as it is safe. Because the sooner we diagnose kidney disease, the better. Let's talk about the correct treatment for stage 3. If you want to improve kidney function in stage 3, all the considerations I've made about stage 1 and 2 are still good. So, keep getting checked regularly for kidney function, blood pressure, and blood sugar levels. The tests for kidney function should be done more frequently now. And there will be some differences in the renal diet when you are in stage 3. Like in stage 2, it's still a good idea to avoid junk foods and limit sodium and sugar. But in stage 3, potassium may be restricted. I say it may be restricted because it depends on the results of the lab tests. If your doctor sees too much potassium in your tests, then you're going to have to limit the intake in the diet. Not all the patients in this stage have to limit potassium. What's always restricted in stage 3 is phosphorus, and many people don't know about this, okay? Because phosphorus won't kill you, unlike potassium. So many people only care about potassium-rich foods, but you should also care about phosphorus if you want to improve your kidney health. Now, if you want to know what foods have potassium, what foods have phosphorus, how much you can eat, and more, watch this video up here. But remember that eating plenty of fruit and vegetables will help you getting the nutrients and the vitamins your body needs. Now, stage 3 CKD doesn't require dialysis or a kidney transplant. Instead, you will be prescribed certain medications to treat underlying medical conditions that may be contributing to kidney damage. These include angiotensin-converting enzyme, ACE inhibitors, and angiotensin II receptor blockers, ARBs, for high blood pressure, as well as glucose management for diabetes. Your doctor may also prescribe medications to help alleviate the side effects of CKD, such as iron supplements for anemia, calcium vitamin D supplements to prevent bone fractures, diuretics to treat edema if you have that symptom. Vitamin C and vitamin B complex are also usually prescribed to patients in stage 3. This is all you need to manage this disease at this stage. Okay, let's get back to our symptoms table. As you can see, in the later stages, there will be other symptoms that haven't seen before. When kidney function drops below 30%, symptoms like fatigue, swelling, and changes in the urinary patterns are going to be more noticeable. Some patients will also have trouble breathing. But as we can see here in stage 5, when kidneys are no longer able to remove toxins and extra water from the body, that we are going to see a lot more symptoms. Itching, muscle cramps, nausea and vomiting, and more. Now, let's see what the treatments are for these stages. Many of the things that worked in stage 3 are still useful in stage 4 and 5, so I'm not going to repeat them. Like for the other stages, avoiding bad habits and getting checked regularly can really help. There will be significant changes in the renal diet now that the kidneys have lost almost all their filtering ability. We will still need to limit sodium, protein, and cholesterol intake. Like for stage 3, avoid junk foods and packaged foods completely. potassium is usually restricted in stage 4. This is a serious limitation because a lot of the fruit and vegetables that were perfectly healthy are now dangerous. Bananas, avocados, spinach, potatoes, beans, just to name a few, are now to be avoided. Patients usually have a 2000 milligrams per day allowance of potassium and shouldn't eat more than that. In stage 5, fluid intake is going to be restricted too, so this is another thing to consider in the choice of the diet. Patients will have to choose meals that are not making them thirsty. Now, the diet of a renal patient is a really wide topic that I'm really trying to tackle thoroughly here on Double O Kidney. I've made a whole series of videos on how to set up a kidney-friendly diet. Diet is always a very predominant part of the everyday life of a kidney patient. So I'm trying to make things easier for patients, creating recipes healthy and tasty. Also, there are supplements that can help. In the advanced stages, the kidneys will no longer be able to produce hormones needed by our red blood cells and bones and to regulate blood pressure. So, in stage 5, you will also be prescribed a special type of vitamin D that can help solving these issues. Iron will be prescribed too, alongside vitamin B and C. Take all prescribed medications as directed. In addition to taking all prescribed medications, ask your health care provider before adding over-the-counter medications or supplements. See your health care provider regularly. Be sure to report and discuss any new and worsening symptoms with your health care provider. Before stage 5, usually patients are asked to prepare for dialysis. Okay, the situation seems pretty dire right now, but there is a very important thing that I want to tell you. You should never lose hope, and it's normal to be scared, but you can still win this battle. You will want to be put in a transplant list, right? Remember that the median waiting time is about 3 years, but you will be able to get a transplant if you need one eventually. Because every year kidney transplants become more frequent, and now there's even what they call the kidney swap or paired kidney exchange program. It's a pool of donors people can join to help patients getting a kidney from a relative that wouldn't be able to donate to them for compatibility reasons. I've talked about this in one of my previous videos. I'm leaving a link up here. And there are new treatments being developed as we speak for people in stage 5. Stem cells and the artificial implantable kidney, just to name a few. In a matter of years, dialysis and transplant may not be the only options. So, never lose hope. Never. Where to go from here? I've made a playlist on the right, kidney-friendly diet, that you can watch right now to have more detailed information on the topic of the diet. This is all for today, and thank you for watching.